Welcome back. In this step, we would understand an important Maven concept called the build life cycle. I wanted to create a jar for a specific project. There are a lot of steps that are involved, right? First thing is I need to take this Java file. I would need to compile it. The next thing I would need to do is to look at the test code. So test code and compile that piece of code. And once I compile the test code to be able to build a jar, one of the important things is the test should be successful. So I would want to run this test and make sure that the test is running fine. If the test does not run fine, then I don't want to allow it to build the project. For example, how do we run test? Right-click run as JUnit test. So we would actually want to run this test as part of building the entire project. There are basically a sequence of steps that you would need to follow to be able to build a deployable for this specific project. So if I want to create a jar here, I would need to compile Java code. I would need to compile test code. I would need to run the tests. If the tests are all running successfully, then I would need to create a jar for this entire thing. When we were writing AND scripts, we used to write code for each. We used to write XML configuration for each of these things. So first I would write something to compile the Java code. Then I would write something to compile the test code. Then make the resources available to the tests. And then run the tests, write logic to check if everything is working fine or not. What Maven does is it defines a Maven lifecycle. The important things in a Maven lifecycle go like this. First thing what Maven does is it validates the project. Then it does the compile. So the compile has two important steps. One is compiling the source code. The next thing is compiling the test code. Third stage is test, where all the unit tests in your project are run. If all the unit tests are successful, it would go to the package state, where it would actually build a jar. If you have any integration tests, then those are run. And then we would go to the verify stage, after which it goes to the install stage. Install is basically taking your artifact which is generated and putting it to a local repository. And deploy is where you take the generated artifact and deploy it to a remote Maven repository. We will talk about remote Maven repository and local Maven repository in one of the next videos. For now, you can see that there is a specific life cycle which is defined when you do anything with Maven. How do I execute this Maven life cycle? It's by a command mvn clean install. So I've actually opened up terminal and did a cd to the folder where this specific project is in. So I just did a cd to that folder. In there, I'm now executing mvn clean install. So this would actually execute all the steps in the life cycle up to install. So when I do mvn install, it executes all the steps in the life cycle up to install. So it does a validate, then it does a compile, then it runs the tests. Once the tests are successful, it would go on to the package and integration test, verify, and the install. You would see that the last step, installing, is in here. To get better control over this, actually you can actually run this from Eclipse. If you have problem setting Maven standalone, then I would recommend you to do the same thing in here. All that you need to do is right-click, run as Maven build, mvn clean install. When you're running it inside Eclipse, you don't need to give mvn. So all that you need to give is clean install and say run. Now you'd see that all the output appears in the console. What I would do is I'll let this run and then filter through the console to show you the important stuff. When I ran mvn clean install, the first thing it did was clean, because that's the clean command that we gave. It deletes everything from the target folder. So from the target folder, everything is deleted. Next thing, what it does is compile, right? So it makes the resources available and then does a compile. So the default compile, so it's actually compiling one source file. So it's compiling the source code, then it compiles the test code. So this is where the test compile comes into picture. It compiles the test code which is present. So since everything ran fine, then it goes to the Maven Surefire plugin to be able to run the test. So this is where the test execution happens. So we completed the validate, the compile, we compiled the code. Next, we are in the test phase. So this is where the tests are running. So the entire test runs. There's one test which is already there in our project. You don't really need to worry about the details of that specific test. But you can see that the test ran successfully. So it says failures are zero, errors are zero. So it's fine. So next it goes into the build phase. So this is basically the package phase. So it's building a jar file. So it's actually taking all the class files, putting it into the jar file. Then it's actually doing a install. So it's actually installing it into a local repository. You can see that each one of these is executed one after the other. This is what is called a build lifecycle. In Maven, there's a predefined lifecycle for all projects. What happens is Maven does a lot of pre-configured stuff. One of the important pre-configuration which is present in Maven is that all source code, all the main source code should be in source main Java. All the Java source code is here. All your property files and all your configuration should be in source main resources. All your test files should be in source test Java. We don't really have a source test resources in here, but if we had a source, any resources for the test files, they should go into source test resources. Maven also defines a predefined life cycle. So it says these are the different steps when you create a package for your project. One of the important things with Maven is it makes these steps common to all the projects. If you're going to another project, then you would exactly expect the same thing. So if you see something in source main Java, you know that it's source code. If you do see something in source test Java, you know that that's test code. So it standardizes things across different projects. Maven does this through this concept called convention over configuration. So through convention over configuration, Maven defines a few predefined things like what is your source folder, what is your test folder, where are your properties file present, what is the order in which the different steps are executed. This would help in standardizing things across projects. So what we looked at in this specific video is A, what is build lifecycle? And at the end, we looked at convention over configuration. Until the next step, bye-bye.